Hey guys, Mecha-san here with another Watchmojo Top 10 video here. This one's about the top video game franchises with the best lore here. Yeah, I mean, I actually very much enjoy learning about video game lore and everything. Destiny had one of the richest lore. I mean, not the richest, but it was pretty rich as far as I was aware, especially when in the first Destiny, where you pick up all these Grimoire cards and everything. I know that a lot of people were upset because, oh, you gotta log out of Destiny if you're on, like, the PC and stuff like that and go on the internet, see everything, but, no, you could just go to, the Destiny app right here and look at the Grimoire cards there. You don't have to, on your phone, you didn't have to log off Destiny on the computer and go online. It's just right here on your phone here, and it's actually much easier on your phone, actually. Because, you know, they're cards, basically. But yeah, they got rich lore with a book of, with all the lore about them, the various aliens and the individual aliens and everything. Even the Book of Sorrows and all that stuff. It was very rich here. And of course, other lores like, well, the lore that's currently going on with Halo is immense. The lore we got with Mass Effect, of course. The thumbnail here for this video, it showed the lore for Fallout, which it is interesting as well. I'm still upset because Bethesda has said that they don't plan on really including the rest of the world. They stick it only to America. And I don't know, that's a missed opportunity here. We do learn a little bit about what goes on in the rest of the world before the Great War that fucked everything over, and some little tidbits here and there, but God, really just want to know more about the rest of the world, just how, what they say and everything, their news, artifacts, whatever, but no, if we took it out of America, it wouldn't be Fallout anymore, and yeah, just, that just seems like you're uncomfortable, like you're afraid of going out of your box. Of course, some of the fantasy stuff, of course, would be probably Dragon Age, The Witcher, games I have not played and don't plan on playing because not really big on the fantasy stuff for the most part. There are exceptions, of course, but those two games doesn't really interest me to play. So, yeah, let's see here. Look, wait, I think The Witcher is based on a book series, so does that really count? Let's take a look here.
The world doesn't always revolve around your main character.
Yep. Welcome to Watchmojo. Metal Gear, that's true. Yeah, because Jesus.
Top 10 video game franchises with the best lore.
I'm looking forward to learning about the man behind the legend.
For more gaming videos, yeah, like, check out our when did the first game take place exactly? Like the 70s or 60s or 80s? Yeah, I think it was the 80s, but tech was so much more advanced there.
For this list, we're considering lore as key elements or details of a video game's world or history that make it feel as rich, vibrant, and alive as our own. Regardless of whether or not you, the player, actually interact with these story elements, they are details that make up the general world building. We're only focusing on franchises Halo. That originated as video games, so don't expect to see games that started out as films or novels.
Yeah, like Star Wars.
Or, unfortunately, The Witcher.
Oh, okay, I had a feeling. Nice! That's cool.
Number 10, Deus Ex.
Oh! I think I'm gonna play Mankind Divided. But I like this game. I like the computer revolution.
Dystopian future where corporations influence every aspect of day-to-day life. Can you imagine? Anyway.
Yeah, okay, you know, I decided Deus Ex, Human Revolution, Mankind Divided is going to be my next, like, Let's Play since I just beat The Evil Within 2.
Around our books, magazines, and news reports covering everything from small events like earthquakes to bigger, more influential aspects like research into mechanical augmentation, rampant terrorist activity, and even experimentation on babies.
Whoa,
it's
really?
A very happy story.
Oh, yeah, Adam Jensen.
A vibrant world where daily struggles
yeah, the
life.
Like genetic enhancements and everything like that. Because it's why he can you have augmentations without neuropazine. StarCraft, yeah. I gotta play Legacy of Void. I still haven't even unboxed that thing. The collector's edition.
Warring alien races and leaving very little unexplored. Blizzard's real-time
I've read the entire, all, like, the StarCraft itself. Ghost books, like Ghost, Nova, the freaking, Ghost Academy manga, and eventually Spectres. I even got some of the other books that I gotta read that. The universe and factions that inhabit. Even the latest one, written by Timothy Zahn. Or the different Protoss cultures, like the Tel'Dai. Oh, boy, yes. The universe is overflowing with my life for ire. Shape the planets and characters you encounter. Oh, I can't see this. I don't want to be fooled.
Number 8, Fallout. Our
ancestors first. Yes, Fallout. And Fallout 76 is going to be probably set in the earliest in time. The world may have been blown away. I mean, only 75 years after the whole thing. That way.
In an alternate timeline where the USSR is still kicking and where China remains deeply communist, the tension and ensuing power struggle between major countries is incredibly detailed.
Isn't communist right now?
With the launching of nukes, the spread of viruses that
with the fact that they pretty much banned Twitch, how are they not communists?
Struggling to survive in the aftermath, the lore of Fallout is heartbreaking and eerily rooted in society's greatest fear.
Yes, disease,
and total destruction.
Yeah, I still haven't beaten Fallout 3 or 4 right here.
One thing you should know about us.
I should do live streams.
Number 7, Metal Gear.
Metal Gear. Nuclear weapons disposal. 1988, damn. On Shadow Moses Island in Alaska's Fox Archipelago.
Was attacked and captured by Next Generation Special Forces. Set against the backdrop of the Cold
Phantom
War,
Pain.
Following the split up of the influential philosophers into global superpowers, the billions of dollars the group left behind drives nations to exploit and destroy their own people, and even double-cross their agents in a bid for power.
Of course.
And even as their influence falls, the corruption of shadow organizations like the Patriots and the rise of private military companies take
a
cycle of struggle, stretching their conflicts throughout the world and undermining any efforts for peace. Making this parallel Earth a volatile and dangerous place.
Nice catch! One bullet.
Number 6, Halo.
Halo, of course. You have to use the original, could use the anniversary version.
From the Forerunners and their Halos dealing with the parasitic flood and
the precursors, ancient humans,
to the High Prophets manipulating the Covenant's beliefs to gain power,
to Oni's like machinations, meddling, and just overall being assholes and evil. Essentially, the closest thing there is to actual evil in this world.
The Covenant's own Great Schism.
Now the Covenant's dead.
Manipulation at the root of the Spartan program.
Oh boy!
Just how hotly contested space was even before.
I mean, I can't decide whether other Cortanas created them new, truly evil, the evil one, or Sony. I mean, I know what some of the creator did. Okay, Dark Souls, don't know. Transitory lands of the Lords of Cinder converge. Yeah, I'm good with this one. I don't play Dark Souls.
Things come to an end, even in Lordran, especially in Lordran. With the
Lord drama.
Of the Age of Fire, power hungry.
Nice, cool dragon statue. Oh, let me get. That's a real dragon. While the rise just frozen. Of the
hollow curse kept him from dying. Every attempt to rekindle the flame has failed to bring back the glory days, leaving the world as a worn-out, broken place by the time you set foot on your adventure. The actions of people throughout history had lasting impact on the areas you visit, like the Abyss or Blighttown, leaving behind items and small details hidden in the architecture. These serve to connect you to these moments from a bygone era, making them that much creepier and lifelike.
And man sees not light, but only endless nights.
Number 4, The Legend of Zelda.
Wow, 1987, damn. But for the while, I gotta plug in my Switch.
The theme in the series is an eternal battle between good and evil over the Triforce. The ancient wish-granting relic imbued.
Yeah, no, and Link is constantly reincarnated and everything, but, jeez, Hyrule changes so drastically every incarnation.
Be afflicted by its presence.
Yeah, it's always changing.
Prosperous, Skyloft to the Great Sea, the world is consistent
Wind Waker.
With songs, stories, races, and landmarks that show off the ravages of time and will have
It's like, do we just go to a different part of this world, or is it the same area of Hyrule? Just, it's changed after so long.
Number 3,
Mass Effect. Can't gain their trust. I would like a continuation to Andromeda. Just be smart, learn, and take as much time as you need.
Frontier for humans, but it's old news for races that have a very long history of conflict and shaky alliances, like the Krogan.
Of course, I would also like to see, I don't know.
It's thanks to these relationships.
First contact with like those surrounding extinct races. The Krogan, like it developed Krogan rebellions. Victorians, First Contact War. There's so much, so much.
Open some of those codexes, and you'll find a lot of.
Oh boy, yes. I crack those open every time I play. I love listening to the narration.
Number two, the Elder Scrolls.
In their tongue, is Dovahkiin.
Yeah, I don't care. I will say, I saw the supposedly most powerful armor in the game.
The continent of Tamriel contains within it thousands of years of history.
Definitely my style.
Taking place centuries apart.
The dragonic theme, red and black, it's cool looking, in my opinion.
Some of it through the plot of each game, there are hundreds of tomes to collect detailing the histories of everything from the ancient races like the Nades to the Baron Zaya and even to Skyrim's Civil War. Whether it's important information or not, here's a world that's almost as deep and fleshed out as our own, with towns, folk songs, and legends aplenty.
Is there any wonder why it takes Bethesda so long to make a brand new game?
Economic and military past of the troubled continent.
At this point, they might as well just make it invaded from another faraway continent come in.
A few honorable mentions.
That'd be cool. Silent Hill. You know, I was kind of looking forward to playing PT. Oh, at least interested. But too bad. Final Fantasy VII. Jesus Christ. Well, I mean, that's super popular. I can't wait for the remake. Bioshock! I mean, yeah, I'd like to go back there.
Number one, Warcraft.
Really? I'm sorry, I'm not that big of a fan. Not, again, you guys fantasy on playing Warcraft.
Tens of thousands of years of detailed history.
I did enjoy the live-action movie.
Archimon's War of the Ancients,
I don't know why people thought it was Azeroth is so bad from like that. I thought it was pretty good.
That towns and even
especially the freaking orcs and the designs.
Helping to connect you with this
the work on them was great, and they were people. They had their own culture and way of doing things. I thought it was a good movie.
Ancient forces you read about and eternal struggles between the Horde and the Alliance.
Although, I mean, it actually made me want to know more about the original source material. So again, how is that a bad thing? I mean, for at least for someone like me who not big.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out these other great clips from Watchmojo and subscribe for new videos every day.
Yeah, pretty good. A pretty good list here. I'm kind of happy that Mass Effect was higher in the list than Halo. But because I don't think anyone ever thought Halo would get that deep of a lore. But Mass Effect already had that deep of a lore, like after, like pretty much in its original inception, they planned all that. But yeah, Halo, that got crazy with the precursors, the fact that there was an ancient branch of humans that were so advanced they actually rivaled the Forerunners in a way. Just learning everything I got here, and the San Shayum were even more advanced before. That would have been, yeah, Jesus. You know, we need I'm about to say we need an animated film of that, but yeah, I remember then the adaptation of The Fall of Reach, which was, no, it should have been called frickin' Boot Camp, because that's what it was, and just, oh boy. Yeah, I think I'm still a little pissed the fact that the Battle of Kai Seti 4, it was a UNSC frigate versus a frickin' Covenant battlecruiser. Okay, in the book, it was, I think, I forgot what ship it was exactly, but it was smaller than a UNSC frigate. And the whole point of it was to emphasize just how outmatched the UNSC is compared to the Covenant, with a point where a smaller ship can easily devastate. See, a much bigger UNSC counterpart. If it was really a freaking a CCS class battlecruiser, that frigate would have been destroyed long before the Spartans ever got into their Pelicans to go back to the plan and get their Mjolnir armor. I'm sorry. Going off topic here. Yes, Fallout. I have been meaning to get back into Fallout. Do a live stream even, but then, you know, other things to do. Deus Ex, yes, that's something I gotta play. Mankind Divided, yeah, that's gotta be my next Let's Play. My next Let's Play, yeah. And talking about babies, yeah, they're referring to Adam Jensen here, who was genetically enhanced. Basically, think almost like what did with Kira Yamato in Gundam Seed, how he was genetically enhanced and allowed to develop in the test tube, especially. Just like that. The ultimate coordinator. So, yeah, boy, you got, yeah, I can tell you this, man. If there was ever a Mass Effect, for those of you planning to do like a cross Gundam Seed, Mass Effect crossover, remember one thing. The whole genetic enhancement coordinator thing means nothing in Mass Effect. That's a practice that Systems Alliance in canon has done before. The point where even people can have like essentially babies that develop like Kira Yamato, okay? It's genetic enhancement is nothing. So yeah. But yeah, it's because of that those genetic enhancement that he can have those mechanical augmentations without any rejection. That's why he doesn't need neuroprotein or anything like that to stem the body from rejecting the implants. So yeah, and yeah, Legend of Zelda, again, I gotta get to playing that. And StarCraft, I gotta play Legacy of the Void. Well, okay, that's enough. It's enough gushing, but it's a very good list overall. Fallout, yeah, I mean, Elder Scrolls, I can see that. I mean, with how much work they put in the game, it's clear it's their like flagship title, even better than Fallout here. They really put a lot of work into this game, having so much backstory, even little trivia from what I gathered here, that doesn't matter in the long run, but hey, it fleshes out the world. That's good, so it's good to know. And you never know, they might be able to use something they said in like Fallout 2, a little bit of story bit, and maybe it'll play a part in like the sixth or seventh game, I don't know. Like a continuity like that, I appreciate. And everyone, as always, comment down below what you all thought. Like and subscribe for more videos, hit the bell icon to be notified of when I update. Until the next one, this is Mecha-san, logging out.